tonight, Prime Minister Alan Shastney has gone into quarantine and has been tested for COVID-19. The future of Carnival 2020 hangs in the balance, and Tourism Minister Dominic Fayde slams reports that the government is hiding COVID-19 secrets. All this and more coming up in tonight's broadcast.
This is the Hot 7 Nightly News with Lovelies and Amy Green.
Good evening. It is Tuesday, the 17th of March, 2020. Welcome to the Hot 7 TV Nightly News. We're on Flow Channel 117. The broadcast is also being simulcast on Kiss FM Radio, on our mobile app, and the Caribbean Hot 7 Facebook page. I'm Rochelle Gonzalez, filling in for lovely St. Amy Joseph. Thank you for joining us. The fate of Prime Minister Alan Shastney has been plunged into uncertainty after it was announced on Tuesday afternoon that he has gone into self-quarantine and is in waiting to find out whether he has been struck down by the dreaded COVID-19. The news, which is initially dismissed as another hoax, was soon confirmed by the Office of the Prime Minister. We have more in this report.
We're also seeing that there should be good practice like social distancing, which is not happening here today. And I hope the next time we are in gatherings and our party has taken that position, that if we have gatherings, we ensure that we take these measures. So I advise that the next time you meet, and then you should ensure that you're a few feet from each other.
This joke made by leader of the opposition, Philippe J. Pierre, during a NEMAC meeting on Monday morning could not be more ironic. This is because one day after he joked about persons keeping their distance to prevent the spread of COVID-19, it was announced on Tuesday afternoon that the health of Prime Minister Alan Shastney is hanging in the balance as he has been quarantined and is currently awaiting test results to find out whether he is positive for COVID-19 or not. This information surfaced on social media and was quickly dismissed as another internet hoax, a new trend which has made the dissemination of false news and misinformation popular. However, hours later, the news was confirmed in an official letter from the Office of the Prime Minister, which read, quote, "Please note that Prime Minister Honorable Alan Shastney was, as of this morning, feeling unwell and in accordance with the established protocols, went into self-quarantine. The Prime Minister immediately stayed away from all his meetings and engagements. In keeping with the protocols, as advised by the Chief Medical Officer, the Prime Minister has been tested for COVID-19 and we await the results. As soon as the results are available, the public will be informed." End quote. This information has essentially plunged the health of the entire cabinet, as well as stakeholders of the National Emergency Management Advisory Committee, into uncertainty, as the PM recently sat with NEMAC on Monday to address the concerns surrounding COVID-19. The PM was also shown in his official address to the nation on the same matter, with the vast majority of his cabinet and Attorney General Stephen Julian standing behind him. If positive for the virus, this could lead to the top stakeholders of NEMAC, the cabinet, and members of the opposition St. Lucia Labour Party being forced into quarantine as well, possibly crippling the island. Reporting for Hot 7 News, I'm Rochelle Gonzalez. Just one day prior to the news of Prime Minister Alan Shastney's health scare, the nation tuned in as he delivered his address to the nation on Monday, March 16th, with regards to the current COVID-19 situation on Ireland. Jacques Wooding tells us more.
In an address to the nation on Monday night, Prime Minister Alan Shastney appeared with members of the cabinet beside him to update the nation on current developments in St. Lucia's battle with COVID-19. After asserting that St. Lucia has to date recorded 2 imported cases of the virus, the PM announced that 3 major hotels are to close amid the global crisis.
The virus continues to have untold economic impact globally, and in particular St. Lucia. It's unfortunate we've received recent indication of the impending closure of 3 major hotels.
Shastney said the impact of coronavirus should be treated as an imminent disaster, such as a hurricane. He recalled that it was for this reason last month saw the activation of the National Emergency Advisory Committee, NEMAC. The PM said since the crisis began, there has been remarkable cooperation and collaboration at all levels of society.
Since the crisis began, there has been remarkable cooperation and collaboration at all levels of the society. I am thankful to the Leader of the Opposition and the members of both Houses of Parliament for their participation and support in our efforts. Our doctors, nurses, and other health personnel air and sea ports personnel, firemen and women, the police have all been going beyond the call of duty. They work longer hours than usual, sacrificing time away from family and loved ones. I've met many of them in recent days, and my government remains committed to ensure that they do everything to support, protect, and all resources to protect our frontline professionals.
He recalled that all schools will remain closed with all school-related activities suspended until further notice. The PM described that this measure is the first step in social distancing protocol, which should not be treated as a regular school vacation.
This is the first step in social distancing protocol and should not be treated as a regular school vacation. The Ministry of Education is collaborating with our telecommunications service providers and will shortly advise of alternative means of delivering our educational instructions to the students.
He observed that as a first step, the St. Lucia Jazz Festival has been cancelled, and there will be a meeting of officials of the culture and creative industries on Tuesday to discuss a way forward for Carnival and other events. For 7 News, I am Jacques Wooding.
The future of Carnival 2020 continues to hang in the balance as the Cabinet of Ministers engage with the events company to discuss the annual cultural event in light of the COVID-19 crisis. A proposal has been put forward to the government of St. Lucia by the Carnival Bands Association. However, the association maintains that safety of all involved is the number one priority.
Carnival 2020 is skating on thin ice thanks to the COVID-19 crisis that has crippled the operations and livelihoods of St. Lucians even before the announcement of the first case on island on Friday the 13th of March 2020. On Tuesday, March 17th, the fate of the national event continued to hang in the balance after the Cabinet of Ministers met with the Carnival Bands Association to discuss Carnival as well as other upcoming mass gathering events planned for the year. President of the CBA, Barry George, said the answers will be given before the end of the week.
After the meeting, the stakeholders attended the meeting. A proposal was given to the government, and after the meeting, it was decided that the government will now go back to the wider cabinet to make a final decision, and within 48 hours, they will give us a final detail as to what the government of St. Lucia will be deciding with regards to the fate of the other national events, including Carnival, for 2020, knowing of the impact, the economical impact and the health impact with regards to the coronavirus going on right now.
George said health and safety takes precedence in this situation. However, there is a lot at stake.
We are concerned about health and safety as priority number one. And of course, we have to understand that Carnival organizations, especially the bands, is something that takes about 8 to 10 months of preparation. And a number of our members who have launched as early as December have made thousands of dollars in terms of investment, and all and contracts and bookings and all of this need to be considered because there's a serious economic impact on those bands who already aggressively who've been promoting St. Lucia Carnival already. So that needs to be considered as well, the economic impact on the various bands that have been spending and already planning for the Carnival and already in the production of Carnival and costumes. I'm sure by now you probably know that at least 3 of our biggest bands already closed. It means that when you hear a band close, persons internationally have booked already, paid deposits on costumes already, and planning, you know, to come to St. Lucia. So all that has to be considered as well.
Minister with responsibility for culture and creative industries, Fortuna Bellrose, said all factors of what has been presented to the cabinet will be considered.
The government of St. Lucia is committed to ensuring that the health of our citizens remain at the fore in this crisis. And of course, we'll be working with all parties to ensure that we make those decisions that are just pertinent to us moving forward as a country.
The St. Lucia Parade of the Live Bands is scheduled for July 20th to the 21st. However, it has been suggested that the event be moved to the third week of October 2020. Reporting for Hot 7 News, I'm Rochelle Gonzalez.
Tourism Minister Dominic Fayde has rebuffed comments that suggest that there is a wall of secrecy surrounding COVID-19 cases and the level of exposure that may have taken place at resorts on island. The minister is adamant that full disclosure has been made to hotel staff where COVID-19 exposure may have occurred.
The discretion by health authorities and the government not to disclose the names of the hotels where foreign nationals stayed before testing positive for COVID-19 has been heavily criticized by members of the public. On Monday, during a NEMAC meeting, the tourism minister addressed concerns that workers within the tourism sector are being left as sitting ducks at these resorts. Minister Dominic Fayde vehemently denies that there has been any secrecy where it concerns workers at the hotels. He says rumors have caused a state of shock and panic among hotel staff on island.
One of the challenges that we are facing is the misinformation that is being circulated. So some of the employees heard, well, it is the hotel that they work at. Another employee hears that it's not that hotel, it's our hotel. And so the rumor mill is also suggesting that somehow the management of hotels are hiding from their staff where the guests actually emanated from, which is an absolute falsity. The hotels that where the guests are staying, they've been nothing but transparent. In fact, yesterday, I believe that there was a meeting by one of the hotels to help to calm the nerves of their staff, to help to encourage them. And I want to thank the Ministry of Health and the Ministry of Tourism for joining that meeting to give that support that was required.
Minister Fayde says fighting misinformation and rumor has become a critical focus in the response to COVID-19 as officials try to navigate this catch-22 of scaling back tourism to promote health and keeping hotels operating to help cushion the economy.
Just this morning, I received a voice note saying that we have some 25 cases. And somebody said the latest case is somewhere in Viewfort. And there was even a voice note which suggested that a government minister was one of the cases. So the rumor mill is churning so fast. And if there is one enemy that we face in responding to this crisis, is that rumor mill. And it's causing an unfortunate panic. It's causing shock. And it's unnecessary. And we all have to hold hands together and join forces from our various positions of leadership to ensure that we bring the correct information to people.
The Ministry of Tourism, the St. Lucia Tourism Authority, and the St. Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association have all come together to form a new subcommittee to ensure the dissemination of timely and factual information to fight what the minister described as an assault of misinformation that continues to spread. Reporting for Hot 7 News, I'm Rochelle Gonzalez.
Still to come, the Department of Health seeks outside help. The race to bring St. Lucians home from Martinique is on, and the Police Welfare Association president recovers from an attack. All this and more coming up after this break.